morning with Paul Summers from Asra Minerals. Paul, good morning. Good to meet you.
Morning, Andrew.
Look, Paul, just firstly, give us a brief introduction here to Asra.
Okay. Asra was a junior gold explorer, been kicking around since actively in the Leonora area since 2008, growing a gold resource, which is approximately 150,000 ounces at the moment, and continuing to grow. We have gone through quite a radical change in a chance find. We're not one of those companies looking for rare earths, but in late last year, we came across some unusual ground in the central of our gold area. And after hitting it with a PXRF gun, we got very high yttrium readings. And this ground had been extensively drilled for gold, but we weren't getting the indicators for gold in this particular area, but had done a lot of drilling. So we suddenly found ourselves with a very advanced rare earths project.
Well, look, you say here the rare earths and critical minerals endowment is shaping up to be unique on an international scale. Just how so?
Okay, so it's something we can actually challenge most companies with. We currently believe we're the only regolith oxide heavy ratio rare earths discovery in the world at the moment. We're a weathered occurrence from surface to 20 metres before we hit hard rock. Hard rock also is revealing critical minerals as well, but we've only been concentrating on this very, very large area of regolith oxide, heavily weathered, and without any of the nasties of thorium and uranium, which makes it quite unique. So we're not an ionic clay, and we're not a hard rock, so costs of production will be greatly reduced, including we don't have those nasties for processing.
And you've got existing mining infrastructure nearby.
Correct. So we're basically next to the King of the Hills mine operated by Red 5. And what makes us also very unique is it's our ground. We own the Tamula Pastoral Station, which Red 5 are on, which also St. Barbara's Jasper Pit is on, and all our ground is on it as well. We extend out of the station area as well, but we have a greatly accessible access to water because obviously it's our pastoral station. It sits on the Tamula Aquifer, which is a huge advantage because it's a very, very large aquifer, and we won't have those problems with water that, for example, Linus has experienced in Malaysia, because they've basically run out of water there, as they've announced, and that's a massive advantage.
Have you got a rare earths resource?
We don't as yet, but it is our plan this quarter, hopefully, depending on the laboratory timing. We hope to release an MRE in this final quarter of the year. We're certainly ready for it with the amount of drilling we've done. We estimate we probably need to do about 3,000 metres more at a maximum to get an indicated resource. Our spacing has been very, very close and the drilling very extensive. So we're currently awaiting metallurgy, and we expect metallurgy within the next couple of weeks. And that'll be our first pass metallurgy. And obviously, for those that understand rare earths, metallurgy really indicates the commerciality of extraction.
You've done some initial MET studies. You say they've been encouraging.
They have been. We know that we can actually leach the material, which is quite exciting for us. And now we just need to know what we're getting from the various acid structures that we're using to try and liberate the rare earths. But I will make the point, because we're talking about rare earths, we're not only actually a rare earths project and gold project, we also have critical minerals. And I think the thing that's getting passed over is this is a massive scandium and cobalt deposit, absolutely massive. We're blown away with the size of this. And if it extracts easily, it's going to be very, very impacting on the world market.
And so what are your plans to advance these commodities?
all depends on metallurgy. So in the it is really the billion-dollar question at the moment. We're just waiting on our first pass metallurgy, and then obviously metallurgy is quite scientific and there'll be fine-tuning. But everything indicates to us being able to extract these rare earths and critical minerals quite easily. Our early assaying with Aqua Regia has recovered a very high ratio of around 70%. So we're encouraged by that and hoping that our metallurgy will have a high rate of recovery.
And what about plans, Paul, as far as moving the gold story forward?
We're treating the company as a binary project at the moment. Obviously, gold is a little bit down at the moment. So our focus is obviously on the rare earths. But we are continuing our exploration program. And with not much more drilling, we believe we can boost the ounces that we currently have in that resource. And we're also looking at a new area where we've done a little bit of drilling and got very, very high recovery at a place called the Diorites, which historically has not been investigated since the early 1900s, but was one of the highest recovery mining areas of the Yilgarn. And it's quite amazing that it's been forgotten about it.
Just a quick word, Paul, before you take off. I understand you're building a team of experts here.
We're hoping to make some very significant announcements to our expanded team in the next couple of weeks. So watch this space.
Good to speak this morning. Paul, thanks very much.
Thank you, Andrew.